Summer is almost here, and that means we may be thinking about traveling. We also might be considering taking Fido along on that trip. Talk to Dr. Jenna Hunter at Main Street Veterinarian Clinic here in Lumberton, and that's a big topic, you know, deciding whether you want to take your dog on vacation with you or not. Big responsibility.
Right. Yeah, absolutely, because we forget about, of course, making sure that our destination will accept our pets, be it a hotel or a family member. And then, of course, how does that pet travel?
Yeah.
Are they?
Some cats and dogs love that car, but others don't.
Absolutely. There are some that will just jump in and go anywhere, and then there's those ones that pant and whine and holler and meow until you get to your destination. And so those are the ones that we're mainly concerned about.
What are our options?
Absolutely. Well, first and foremost, if your pet is going to travel with you, the absolute best thing is make sure they're either kenneled or seatbelted in some way. Mainly because for the same reasons that we never know who is pulling out in front of us or coming up behind us, I have too many animals that come in having gone to the back seat or the dashboard from slamming on the brakes. Sure. So keeping them confined also actually helps control the anxiety somewhat as well. They don't feel like they're so unsteady. On some of these animals that they're a little more anxious, there are several different medications to speak with your veterinarian about. Something as simple as an antihistamine on up to something a little bit more potent to kind of just take the edge off. It won't knock them out, but it'll make them a little bit more sleepy than normal.
Yeah, you said it though, but very important to not let the dog roam around the car while you're driving. I mean, you think talking on a cell phone is bad. Wait till the dog gets tied up under your foot.
Absolutely, and that's the biggest thing, and a lot of our dogs are anxious, and that's why they whine and they move about, and most people think they want to be with us. Well, they kind of do, but it's because they aren't very comfortable. And so getting under your feet, getting in your lap, getting in that steering wheel is dangerous to us and then everybody else on the road with us, as well as our pets.
Okay. Pit stops. Everyone has to stop to use the restroom, including your pets.
Absolutely. Stop to get them a little bit of little tiny bit of food and water, and, of course, relieve themselves along the way. Absolutely necessary, at least with our dogs.
And most highway rest stops have dog areas.
Absolutely. Pet areas are for sure there, and take advantage of them.
Yeah. Hey, they've become popular, but some people don't take their pets along, and there are, what, pet hotels? Hotels and options like that?
Absolutely. All around here in the Golden Triangle, we have everything from either veterinary offices all the way to specific boarding facilities with special little hotel suites for the dogs and cats. And then also, too, there's pet sitters. Sometimes it's your neighbor, and other times there are bonded pet sitters out there that will do everything from water your plants to bring it in your mail and, of course, taking care of Fido.
Yeah, you brought it up that veterinarians house dogs and cats for that situation. Do you do it here?
Absolutely. We do a small amount here, and not all veterinarians do, but probably at least half of us out there, if not more, you know, offer some type of a boarding facility as well.
Okay, tags always important, especially when you're traveling. You want to make sure those tags are updated and correct.
Absolutely. In case they happen to slip out, that's where a microchip comes in handy if the collar somehow comes off, because it's a permanent implant. But otherwise, having your tags with a current phone number, especially a cell number, is important, and have all your other paperwork, your rabies certificate, your vaccine history, and any medication your pet may need on a daily or even monthly basis, depending on how long you'll be gone.
Okay. Dr. Jenna Hunter, Main Street Veterinarian Clinic. Now we'll go over and check on our pet of the week. Here they are. This week they have two new pups to choose from. They're both females that are very friendly and playful. If you'd like to adopt either of them or any of the other animals at Animal Control in Lumberton, you can call 755-2650.